Hi there. Do you ever worry about whether the government's watching or controlling your social media? I want to tell you how this works in India. We've just gotten breaking news about how the government wants to control the internet, and you should know what's up. Okay, imagine you run an online store and some guy decides to sell an illegal porn DVD on your store. The police come and arrest him, but they also arrest you with him even though you didn't even know that he's selling anything. You're just the owner of the store. This actually happened in India in 2008 and the store's name was Bazi. The courts realized how ridiculous it is to arrest the owner of the store for what the person using the store did, and so they created rules to protect companies like Bazi. Bazi here is what we call an intermediary. An intermediary is any service provider that hosts content created by regular users like you and me. Social media companies like Facebook and Twitter are what we call social media intermediaries in a similar way. Social media companies can literally create networks of information with millions of people. But with great power comes great chaos. So to curb this chaos, countries all over the world have special laws for intermediaries. In India, these are called the intermediary rules and they come under the IT Act. Until 2008, intermediary guidelines were quite limited and they weren't really such a massive deal. But in 2008, after the Bazi fiasco, the government realized that these intermediaries need certain immunity so that they are not held liable for what their users do. Because you can't take a microscope and monitor what every user does every second of every day. So they said, okay, intermediaries, you can have immunity as long as you follow government guidelines, comply with our content takedown requests, give us user information when we ask for it. If you don't, then you stand to lose your immunity. In a matter of years, a lot of us began to realize that big tech is just broken. It's so addictive, it sucks all of our data, it bullies smaller competitors, and sometimes it just breaks the law. But the government proposals to solve this issue have just been awful. In December 2018, Indian Express broke the news that the government is thinking of making social media intermediaries use tech to stop unlawful content in its tracks and to also break our beloved end-to-end encryption if it wants. And everyone was like, whoa, hold on, what? If you use algorithms to censor what we say before we're gonna say it, freedom of speech is just lost. And it's a privacy issue as well. This was a really messy affair. First, the Ministry of Electronics and IT was like, no, we never had any confidential meeting with social media companies where we discussed this. And then they were like, okay, yeah, we did. There wasn't even any public consultation on the matter until after public outrage happened. So after all this public outrage, people have been wondering for some time, what's the outcome of this drama? Well, we've just found out what the government's plan is because they've just come out with their brand new draft intermediary guidelines. For the first time ever, OTT platforms like Netflix and Hotstar and news platforms like maybe The Caravan have come under the intermediary rules, which means that the government wants to be able to just tell them that, yeah, comply with our orders, like for example, taking down any content or suffer blocking. Personally, the scariest thing for me is that the draft rules allow the government to make companies like WhatsApp, Signal, and Telegram break end-to-end encryption if it wants to find who sent a particular message. Dude, there are literally hackers who can spoof you and make it look like you sent an anti-national text when you didn't. There isn't even any parliamentary oversight for the process of decryption. The draft rules will make big social media companies deploy tech to identify and remove sexual harassment and child sexual abuse content. And of course, we don't want this content online, but this is a slippery slope towards surveillance culture where people are being pre-censored and, you know, by inaccurate and biased algorithms. Tomorrow, they might want to use the same tech to remove content that isn't sexual harassment. There's a lot more in the rules that looks okay at first, but requires some serious legal scrutiny. So, what's the issue? Social media companies are being not really forced, but actually forced to do what the government wants them to do. Because they have to keep over-complying with rising government demands because they fear losing their immunity, which the government knows that they can't afford to lose if they just want to survive. And there's so much vagueness in the rules. A lot of these compliances go back to government discretion, where it'll get to pick favorites and then follow an oversight process. Who'll win in the end? Big companies, because they're the ones with the resources to negotiate all of these legal and technical complexities. And of course, they're the ones with the cash and the data. But the collateral damage in all of this? Your freedom of speech and privacy. intermediary rules changing is a big deal because every little change totally defines our experience of the internet and has major implications on our freedom of speech and privacy. As citizens of a democracy, you think and tell us if this is the future you want, where governments have more and more control over social media companies. At IFF, we've been working on this for a while. We engage in public advocacy, were interveners in the Madras High Court traceability case, we sent an email campaign to the Ministry of Electronics and IT all the way back in 2018, and we have ongoing analyses and representations. We're funded by regular Indians like you, and we really want to continue doing the work that we do, so please donate to us today.